This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Arnold Alois Schwarzenegger, W. Artzen R., German, born July 30, 1947, is an Austrian-American actor, producer, businessman, investor, author, philanthropist, activist, and former professional bodybuilder and politician. He served two terms as the 38th governor of California from 2003 until 2011. Schwarzenegger began weight training at the age of 15. He won the Mr. Universe title at age 20 and went on to win the Mr. Olympia contest 7 times. Schwarzenegger has remained a prominent presence in bodybuilding and has written many books and articles on the sport. He is widely considered to be among the greatest bodybuilders of all time, as well as bodybuilding's biggest icon. Schwarzenegger gained worldwide fame as a Hollywood action film icon. His breakthrough film was the sword and sorcery epic Conan the Barbarian in 1982, which was a box office hit and resulted in a sequel in 1984. Schwarzenegger appeared in James Cameron's science fiction thriller film The Terminator, which was a massive critical and box office success. Schwarzenegger subsequently reprised the Terminator character in the franchise's later installments in 1991, 2003, and 2015. He appeared in a number of successful films, such as Commando 1985, The Running Man 1987, Predator 1987, Twins 1988, Total Recall 1990, Kindergarten Cop 1990, and True Lies 1994. In 2015, it was announced Schwarzenegger would replace Donald Trump as the host of the Celebrity Apprentice. He was nicknamed the Austrian Oak in his bodybuilding days, Arnie during his acting career, and the Governator, a combination of Governor and the Terminator, during his political career as a Republican. He was first elected on October 7, 2003, in a special recall election to replace then Governor Gray Davis. Schwarzenegger was sworn in on November 17, to serve the remainder of Davis's term. Schwarzenegger was then re-elected on November 7, 2006, in the 2006 California gubernatorial election, to serve a full term as governor, defeating Democrat Phil Angelides, who was California state treasurer at the time. Schwarzenegger was sworn in for his second term on January 5, 2007. In 2011, Schwarzenegger completed his second term as governor. Contents 1 Early life 11 Early adulthood 12 Move to the U.S. 2 Bodybuilding career 21 Powerlifting, weightlifting 211 Personal records 22 Mr. Olympia 23 Steroid use 24 List of competitions 25 Competitive stats 3 Acting career 31 Early roles 32 Action superstar 33 Retirement 34 Return to acting 35 The Celebrity Apprentice 36 Filmography 4 Political career 41 Early politics 42 Governor of California 421 Death of Luis Santos 43 Allegations of sexual misconduct 44 Citizenship 45 Environmental record 46 Electoral history 47 Presidential ambitions 5 Business career 51 Bricklaying business 52 Investments 53 Restaurant 54 Wealth 55 Commercial advertisements 6 Personal life 61 Early relationships 62 Marriage and family 63 Marital separation 64 Accidents and injuries 65 Height 66 Autobiography 67 Vehicles 7 Activism 8 Awards and honors 9 Books 10 See also 11 References 12 Further reading 13 External links 131 Governorship 132 Interviews 133 Film Early life Schwarzenegger was born in Thal, Styria, Austria and christened Arnold Alois. His parents were Gustav Schwarzenegger August 17, 1907 to December 13, 1972 and Aurelia Schwarzenegger née Jaderny, July 29, 1922 to August 2, 1998 Gustav was the local chief of police, and had served in World War II as a Hauptfeldwebel after voluntarily joining the Nazi Party in 1938, though he was discharged in 1943 following a bout of malaria. He married Schwarzenegger's mother on October 20, 1945. He was 38, and she was 23 according to Schwarzenegger. Both of his parents were very strict. Back then in Austria it was a very different world. If we did something bad or we disobeyed our parents, the rod was not spared. Schwarzenegger grew up in a Roman Catholic family who attended Mass every Sunday. Gustav had a preference for his elder son, Meinhard, July 17, 1946 to May 20, 1971, over Arnold. His favoritism was strong and blatant, which stemmed from unfounded suspicion that Arnold was not his biological child. Schwarzenegger has said his father had no patience for listening or understanding your problems. He had a good relationship with his mother and kept in touch with her until her death in later life. Schwarzenegger commissioned the Simon Wiesenthal Center to research his father's wartime record, which came up with no evidence of Gustav's being involved in atrocities. Despite his membership in the Nazi Party and saw Gustav's background received wide press attention during the 2003 California recall campaign at school, Schwarzenegger was apparently in the middle but stood out for his cheerful, good-humored, and exuberant character. Money was a problem in their household. Schwarzenegger recalled that one of the highlights of his youth was when the family bought a refrigerator as a boy. Schwarzenegger played several sports. Heavily influenced by his father, he picked up his first barbell in 1960, when his soccer coach took his team to a local gym at the age of 14. He chose bodybuilding over soccer as a career. Schwarzenegger has responded to a question asking if he was 13 when he started weightlifting. "I actually started weight training when I was 15, but I'd been participating in sports, like soccer, for years, so I felt that although I was slim, I was well developed, at least enough so that I could start going to the gym and start Olympic lifting." However, his official website biography claims, at 14, he started an intensive training program with Dan Farmer, studied psychology at 15 to learn more about the power of mind over body, and at 17, officially started his competitive career. During a speech in 2001, he said, "My own plan formed when I was 14 years old. My father had wanted me to be a police officer like he was my mother wanted me to go to trade school." Schwarzenegger took to visiting a gym in Graz, where he also frequented the local movie theaters to see bodybuilding idols such as Reg Park, Steve Reeves, and Johnny Weissmuller on the big screen. When Reeves died in 2000, Schwarzenegger fondly remembered him, "As a teenager, I grew up with Steve Reeves. His remarkable accomplishments allowed me a sense of what was possible, when others around me didn't always understand my dreams. Steve Reeves has been part of everything I've ever been fortunate enough to achieve." In 1961, Schwarzenegger met former Mr. Austria Kurt Marnell, who invited him to train at the gym in Graz. He was so dedicated as a youngster that he broke into the local gym on weekends, when it was usually closed, so that he could train. "It would make me sick to miss a workout. I knew I couldn't look at myself in the mirror the next morning if I didn't do it." When Schwarzenegger was asked about his first movie experience as a boy, he replied, "I was very young, but I remember my father taking me to the Austrian theaters and seeing some newsreels. The first real movie I saw, that I distinctly remember, was a John Wayne movie." On May 20, 1971, his brother, Meinhard, died in a car accident. Meinhard had been drinking and was killed instantly. Schwarzenegger did not attend his funeral. Meinhard was due to marry Erika Knapp, and the couple had a 3-year-old son. Patrick Schwarzenegger would pay for Patrick's education and help him to emigrate to the United States. Gustav died the following year from a stroke in pumping iron. Schwarzenegger claimed that he did not attend his father's funeral because he was training for a bodybuilding contest later. He and the film's producer said this story was taken from another bodybuilder for the purpose of showing the extremes that some would go to for their sport and to make Schwarzenegger's image more cold and machine-like. In order to fan controversy for the film, Barbara Baker, his first serious girlfriend, has said he informed her of his father's death without emotion and that he never spoke of his brother over time. He has given at least 3 versions of why he was absent from his father's funeral. In an interview with Fortune in 2004, Schwarzenegger told how he suffered what would now be called child abuse at the hands of his father. "My hair was pulled. I was hit with belts. So was the kid next door. It was just the way it was. Many of the children I've seen were broken by their parents," which was the German-Austrian mentality. They didn't want to create an individual. It was all about conforming. "I was one who did not conform, and whose will could not be broken. Therefore, I became a rebel every time I got hit, and every time someone said, 'You can't do this,' I said, 'This is not going to be for much longer, because I'm going to move out of here. I want to be rich. I want to be somebody.'" Early adulthood. Schwarzenegger served in the Austrian army in 1965 to fulfill the 1 year of service required at the time of all 18-year-old Austrian males during his army service. He won the Junior Mr. Europe contest. He went AWOL during basic training so he could take part in the competition, and spent a week in military prison. "Participating in the competition meant so much to me that I didn't carefully think through the consequences." He won another bodybuilding contest in Graz, at Steirer Hof Hotel, where he had placed second. He was voted Best Built Man of Europe, which made him famous. "The Mr. Universe title was my ticket to America. program devised by Bennett, concentrated on improving the muscle definition and power in his legs. Staying in the East End of London helped Schwarzenegger improve his rudimentary grasp of the English language. Also in 1966, Schwarzenegger had the opportunity to meet childhood idol Reg Park, who became his friend and mentor. The training paid off and, in 1967, Schwarzenegger won the title for the first time, becoming the youngest ever Mr. Universe at the age of 20. He would go on to win the title a further three times. Schwarzenegger then flew back to Munich, training for 4 to 6 hours daily, attending business school and working in a health club, Rolf Putziger's gym, where he worked and trained from 1966 to 1968. Returning in 1968 to London to win his next Mr. Universe title, he frequently told Roger C. Field, his English coach and friend in Munich at that time, "I'm going to become the greatest actor." Moved to the U.S. Schwarzenegger with President Ronald Reagan in 1984. Schwarzenegger, who dreamed of moving to the U.S. since the age of 10, and saw bodybuilding as the avenue through which to do so, realized his dream by moving to the United States in September 1968 at the age of 21. Speaking little English there, he trained at Gold's Gym in Venice, Los Angeles, California, under Joe Weider from 1970 to 1974. One of Schwarzenegger's weight training partners was Rick Drayson, a professional wrestler who designed the original Gold's Gym logo in 1973. Schwarzenegger also became good friends with professional wrestler superstar Billy Graham in 1970. At age 23, he captured his first Mr. Olympia title in New York, and would go on to win the title a total of 7 times. The immigration law firm Siskind. Bodybuilding career. Arnold Schwarzenegger. Predecessor Sergio Oliva, 69, Frank Zane, 79. Successor Franco Colombo, 76, 81. Active retired 1980. Competition record men's bodybuilding representing. First 1970 Mr. Olympia, second 1969, first 1970, first 1971, first 1972, first 1973, first 1974, first 1975, first 1980 powerlifting representing. Powerlifting Championship second 1967-80. Competition. He has remained a prominent face in bodybuilding long after his retirement, in part because of his ownership of gyms and fitness magazines. He has presided over numerous contests and awards shows for many years. He wrote a monthly column for the bodybuilding magazines Muscle. 1. Squat 545. Bridges. Lou Ferrigno proved not to be a threat, and a lighter-than-usual Schwarzenegger convincingly won the 1975 Mr. Olympia. Schwarzenegger came out of retirement, however, to compete in the 1980 Mr. Olympia. Schwarzenegger was training for his role in Conan, and he got into such good shape because of the running, horseback riding and sword training, that he decided he wanted to win the Mr. Olympia contest one last time. He kept this plan a secret, in the event that a training accident would prevent his entry and cause him to lose face. Schwarzenegger had been hired to provide color commentary for network television. When he announced at the 11th hour that while he was there, why not compete? Schwarzenegger ended up winning the event with only 7 weeks of preparation after being declared Mr. Olympia for a 7th time. Schwarzenegger then officially retired from competition. Steroid use. Schwarzenegger has admitted to using performance-enhancing anabolic steroids while they were legal, writing in 1977 that steroids were helpful to me in maintaining muscle size while on a strict diet in preparation for a contest. I did not use them for muscle growth, but rather for muscle maintenance when cutting up. He has called the drugs tissue building. In 1999, Schwarzenegger sued Dr. Willy Heap, a German doctor who publicly predicted his early death on the basis of a link between his steroid use and his later heart problems, as the doctor had never examined him personally. Schwarzenegger collected a $10,000 libel judgment against him in a German court in 1999. Schwarzenegger also sued and settled with The Globe, a U.S. tabloid which had made similar predictions about the bodybuilder's future health. List of competitions. Year competition location result and notes. 1965 Junior Mr. Europe Germany first. 1966 Best Built Man of Europe Germany first. 1966 Mr. Europe Germany first. 1966 International Powerlifting Championship Germany first. 1966 NABBA Mr. Universe Amateur London second to Chet Yorton. 1967 NABBA Mr. Universe Amateur London first. 1968 NABBA Mr. Universe Professional London first. 1968 German Powerlifting Championship Germany 1st 1968 IFBB Mr. International Mexico 1st 1968 IFBB Mr. Universe Florida 2nd to Frank Zane 1969 IFBB Mr. Universe Amateur New York 1st 1969 NABA Mr. Universe Professional London 1st 1969 Mr. Olympia New York 2nd to Sergio Oliva 1970 NABA Mr. Universe Professional London 1st defeated his idol Reg Park 1970 Mr. World Columbus Ohio 1st defeated Sergio Oliva for the first time 1970 Mr. Olympia New York 1st 1971 Mr. Olympia Paris 1st 1972 Mr. Olympia Essen, Germany 1st 1973 Mr. Olympia New York 1st 1974 Mr. Olympia New York 1st 1975 Mr. Olympia Pretoria, South Africa first subject of the documentary Pumping Iron 1980 Mr. Olympia Sydney, Australia first competitive stats height, 6 feet 2 inches 188. Was chosen to play the role of Hercules in 1970's Hercules in New York credited under the name Arnold Strong. His accent in the film was so thick that his lines were dubbed after production. His second film appearance was as a deaf-mute hitman for the mob in director Robert Altman's The Long Goodbye 1973, which was followed by a much more significant part in the film Stay Hungry 1976, for which he was awarded a Golden Globe for New Male Star of the Year. Schwarzenegger has discussed his early struggles in developing his acting career. It was very difficult for me in the beginning. Action superstar Schwarzenegger's breakthrough film was the sword and sorcery epic Conan the Barbarian in 1982, which was a box office hit. This was followed by a sequel, Conan the Destroyer, in 1984. Although it was not as successful as its predecessor in 1983, Schwarzenegger starred in the promotional video, Carnival in Rio in 1984. He made his first appearance as the eponymous character, and what some would say was his acting career's signature role, in James Cameron's science fiction thriller film The Terminator. Following this, Schwarzenegger made Red Sonja in 1985. During the 1980s, audiences had an appetite for action films, with both Schwarzenegger and Sylvester Stallone becoming international stars. Schwarzenegger's roles reflected his sense of humor, separating him from more serious action hero films, such as the alternative universe poster for Terminator 2, Judgment Day, starring Stallone in the comedy thriller Last Action Hero. He made a number of successful films, such as Commando 1985, Raw Deal 1986, The Running Man 1987, Predator 1987, and Red Heat 1988. Footprints and handprints of Arnold Schwarzenegger in front of the Grauman's Chinese Theater, with his famous catchphrase, "I'll be back," written in Twins 1988, a comedy with Danny DeVito, also proved successful. Total Recall 1990 netted Schwarzenegger $10. Was based on the Philip K. Dick short story We Can Remember It For You Wholesale. Kindergarten Cop 1990 reunited him with director Ivan Reitman, who directed him in Twins. Schwarzenegger had a brief foray into directing, first with a 1990 episode of the TV series Tales from the Crypt, entitled The Switch, and then with the 1992 telemovie Christmas in Connecticut. He has not directed since. Schwarzenegger's commercial peak was his return as the title character in 1991's Terminator 2, Judgment Day, which was the highest grossing film of 1991. In 1993, the National Association of Theatre Owners named him the International Star of the Decade. His next film project, the 1993 self-aware action comedy spoof Last Action Hero, was released opposite Jurassic Park, and did not do well at the box office. His next film, the comedy drama True Lies 1994, was a popular spy film, and saw Schwarzenegger reunited with James Cameron that same year. The comedy Junior was released, the last of Schwarzenegger's three collaborations with Ivan Reitman and again co-starring Danny DeVito. This film brought him his second Golden Globe nomination, this time for Best Actor. The supernatural thriller End of Days 1999, later followed by the action films The Sixth Day 2000 and Collateral Damage 2002, both of which failed to do well at the box office. In 2003, he made his third appearance as the title character in Terminator 3, Rise of the Machines, which went on to earn over $150. Returned to acting in January 2011, just weeks after leaving office in California, Schwarzenegger announced that he was reading several new scripts for future films, one of them being the World War II action drama With Wings as Eagles, written by Randall Wallace, based on a true story. On March 6, 2011, at the Arnold Seminar of the Arnold Classic, Schwarzenegger revealed that he was being considered for several films, including sequels to The Terminator and remakes of Predator and The Running Man, and that he was packaging a comic book character. The character character was later revealed to be the Governator, star of the comic book and animated series of the same name. Schwarzenegger inspired the character and co-developed it with Stan Lee, who would have produced the series. Schwarzenegger would have voiced the Governator on May 20, 2011. Schwarzenegger's Entertainment Council announced that all movie projects currently in development were being halted. Schwarzenegger is focusing on personal matters and is not willing to commit to any production schedules or timelines. On July 11, 2011, it was announced that Schwarzenegger was considering a comeback film despite his legal problems. He appeared in The Expendables 2 2012, and starred in The Last Stand 2013, his first leading role in 10 years, and Escape Plan 2013, his first co-starring role alongside Sylvester Stallone. He starred in Sabotage, released in March 2014, and appeared in The Expendables 3, released in August 2014. He starred in the fifth Terminator movie Terminator Genisys in 2015. And will reprise his role as Conan the Barbarian in The Legend of Conan, later renamed Conan the Conqueror, in August 2016. His filming of action comedy Why We're Killing Gunther was temporarily interrupted by bank robbers near filming location in Surrey, British Columbia. He was announced to star and produce in a film about the ruins of Sanchingdui called The Guest of Sanchingdui, as an ambassador The Celebrity Apprentice in September 2015. It was announced Schwarzenegger would replace Donald Trump as host of The Celebrity Apprentice. This show, the 15th season of The Apprentice, will air in the 2016-2017 TV season. Filmography. Main article: Arnold Schwarzenegger filmography. Selected notable roles: Hercules in New York as Hercules 1970, Stay Hungry as Joe Santo 1976, Pumping Iron as himself 1977, The Villain as Handsome Stranger 1979, The Jane Mansfield Story as Mickey Hargitay 1980. Conan the Barbarian as Conan 1982, Conan the Destroyer as Conan 1984, The Terminator as The Terminator, T-800 Model 101-1984, Red Sonja as Kalidor 1985, Commando as John Matrix 1985, Raw Deal as Mark Kaminsky, a.k.a. Joseph P. Brenner 1986, Predator as Major Alan Dutch Sheffer 1987, The Running Man as Ben Richards 1987, Red Heat as Captain Ivan Danko 1988, Twins as Julius Benedict 1988, Total Recall as Douglas Quaid, Hausa 1990, Kindergarten Cop as Detective John Kimball 1990, Terminator 2, Judgment Day as The Terminator, T-800 Model 101-1991, Last Action Hero as Jack Slater, himself 1993, True Lies as Harry Tasker 1994, Junior as Dr. Alex Hess 1994, Eraser as U.S. Marshal John Kruger 1996, Jingle All the Way as Howard Langston 1996. Batman and Robin as Mr. Freeze 1997, End of Days as Jericho Kane 1999, The Sixth Day as Adam Gibson, Adam Gibson Clone 2000, Collateral Damage as Gordy Brewer 2002, Terminator 3, Rise of the Machines as The Terminator, T-850 Model 101-2003, Around the World in 80 Days as Prince Happy 2004, The Expendables as Trench 2010, The Expendables 2 as Trench 2012, The Last Stand as Sheriff Ray Owens 2013, Escape Plan as Rottmeyer 2013, Sabotage as John Breacher Wharton 2014, The Expendables 3 as Trench 2014, Maggie as Wade Vogel 2015, Terminator Genisys as The Terminator, T-800 Model 101, The Guardian 2015-478 as Victor 2016, Why We're Killing Gunther as Gunther 2017. Political career. Main article: Political career of Arnold Schwarzenegger. Early politics. Vice President Dick Cheney meets with Schwarzenegger for the first time at the White House. Schwarzenegger has been a registered Republican for many years as an actor. His political views were always well known, as they contrasted with those of many other prominent Hollywood stars, who are generally considered to be a liberal and Democratic-leaning community. At the 2004 Republican National Convention, Schwarzenegger gave a speech and explained he was a Republican because the Democrats of the 1960s sounded too much like Austrian socialists. I finally arrived here in 1968. What a special day it was. I remember I arrived here with empty pockets but full of dreams, full of determination, full of desire. The presidential campaign was in full swing. I remember watching the Nixon-Humphrey presidential race on TV. A friend of mine who spoke German and English translated for me. I heard Humphrey saying things that sounded like socialism, which I had just left, but then I heard Nixon speak. He was talking about free enterprise, getting the government off your back, lowering the taxes and strengthening the military listening to Nixon speak sounded more like a breath of fresh air. I said to my friend, I said, what party is he? My friend said, he's a Republican. I said, then I am a Republican. And I have been a Republican ever since. In 1985, Schwarzenegger appeared in Stop the Madness, an anti-drug music video sponsored by the Reagan administration. He first came to wide public notice as a Republican during the 1988 presidential election, accompanying then Vice President George H.W. Bush at a campaign rally. Schwarzenegger's first political appointment was as chairman of the President's Council on Physical Fitness and Sports, on which he served from 1990 to 1993. He was nominated by George H.W. Bush, who dubbed him Conan the Republican. He later served as chairman for the California Governor's Council on Physical Fitness and Sports under Governor Pete Wilson between 1993 and 1994. Schwarzenegger was a Red Cross ambassador, a ceremonial role fulfilled by celebrities, recording several television, radio public service announcements to donate blood. In an interview with Talk Magazine in late 1999, Schwarzenegger was asked if he thought of running for office. He replied, "I think about it many times. The possibility is there, because I feel it inside." The Hollywood Reporter claimed shortly after that Schwarzenegger sought to end speculation that he might run for governor of California following his initial comments. Schwarzenegger said, "I'm in show business." Of California on the August 6, 2003 episode of The Tonight Show with Jay Leno. Schwarzenegger had the most name recognition in a crowded field of candidates, but he had never held public office and his political views were unknown to most Californians. His candidacy immediately became national and international news, with media outlets dubbing him the Governator, referring to the Terminator movies, see above, and The Running Man, the name of another one of his films, and calling the recall election Total Recall, yet another movie starring Schwarzenegger. Schwarzenegger declined to participate in several debates with other recall replacement candidates, and appeared in only one debate on September 24, 2003. President George W. Bush meets with Schwarzenegger after his successful election to the California governorship on October 7, 2003. The recall election resulted in Governor Gray Davis being removed from office with 554% of the yes vote in favor of a recall. Schwarzenegger was elected governor of California under the second question on the ballot with 486% of the vote to choose a successor to Davis. Schwarzenegger defeated Democrat Cruz Bustamante, fellow Republican Tom McClintock, and others. His nearest rival, Bustamante, received 31% of the vote in total. Schwarzenegger won the election by about 13. Schwarzenegger was entrenched in what he considered to be his mandate in cleaning up gridlock, building on a catchphrase from the sketch Hans and Franz from Saturday Night Live, which partly parodied his bodybuilding career. Schwarzenegger called the Democratic state politicians girly men. Schwarzenegger's early victories included repealing an unpopular increase in the vehicle registration fee, as well as preventing driver's licenses being given out to illegal immigrants. But later he began to feel the backlash when powerful state unions began to oppose his various initiatives. Key among his reckoning with political realities was a special election he called in November 2005, in which four ballot measures he sponsored were defeated. Schwarzenegger accepted personal responsibility for the defeats and vowed to continue to seek consensus for the people of California. He would later comment that no one could win if the opposition raised 160. Schwarzenegger ran for re-election against Democrat Phil Angelides, the California state treasurer, in the 2006 elections, held on November 7, 2006. Despite a poor year nationally for the Republican Party, Schwarzenegger won re-election with 560% of the vote compared with 389% for Angelides, a margin of well over 1 million votes in recent years. Many commentators have seen Schwarzenegger as moving away from the right and towards the center of the political spectrum after hearing a speech by Schwarzenegger at the 2006 Martin Luther King Jr. breakfast. San Francisco Mayor Gavin Newsom said that he's becoming a Democrat, he's running back, not even to the center, I would say center-left. It was rumored that Schwarzenegger might run for the United States Senate in 2010, as his governorship would be term-limited by that time. This turned out to be false, with Schwarzenegger and Senator Dianne Feinstein behind him. President George W. Bush comments on wildfires and firefighting efforts in California. October 2007, Wendy Lee, who wrote an unofficial biography on Schwarzenegger, claims he plotted his political rise from an early age using the movie business and bodybuilding as building blocks to escape a depressing home. Lee portrays Schwarzenegger as obsessed with power and quotes him as saying, "I wanted to be part of the small percentage of people who were leaders, not the large mass of followers. I think it is because I saw leaders use 100% of their potential."